The images that you're about to see are not for the faint of heart.
Kill them. Kill them. Kill them both.
In fact, if you're not an ice-cold apex predator with a fear response so low it borders on stupidity, this might not be the video for you. Baby Bay has been lighting up the scoreboard, and it has been an absolute pleasure to watch the effectiveness of his seemingly impossible playmaking ability. This is Valorant, after all, a tactical shooter. Counter-Strike with abilities, some would say. Strategy and methodical control is important, and patience will often net you the safest winning condition. Then again, whatever game Baby Bay is playing on Jett seems like a lot of fun as well. Initially, Jett was the character for people to make flashy plays with less risk. She dominated the game when paired with an operator as a very elusive hit-and-run style agent who rarely took direct fights. Getting picks and getting out with an advantage made her a staple of every professional team. When you think about it, this is exactly the playstyle that you would expect a scene heavy in Counter-Strike players to develop. With nerfs to the op and the further mixing of styles and ideas from other games, a new breed of Jett is now emerging. Baby Bay's almost arcade shooter approach to the game has been causing major problems for the slower paced and more structured game plan that many ex-Counter-Strike players prefer to play. In this video, we're going to take a look at a couple of plays by FaZe Clan's Jett main and explain why he has become one of the most feared duelists in the game. In this first play, we get to see an old adage at work. Good offense often leads to a good defense, as Baby Bay immediately pushes out of Garage with Bladestorm to take the fight to any attackers that might be in middle. This aggressive push serves two purposes. The first, it gives the defenders super strong map control in mid if the attackers are playing more slowly, and the second is that it sets up Baby Bay to be almost halfway through his flanking maneuver way before the other team would expect him to be. In this round, it's the latter that works out perfectly in his favor as his teammates communicate that there is a C-long push coming. The second the attacking Phoenix uses Run It Back, Baby Bay burns his Tailwind Dash to close the gap even more quickly. He uses the existing Omen Smoke to cover his updraft play and finds not only a scrambling Omen, but the Phoenix's respawn point as well. After killing Omen, he smokes off the retreat and forces the Cypher to push through it in a desperate attempt to save the Phoenix on respawn. It ends up being a super easy 3 kills, made possible only by Baby Bay's ability to hit a ridiculously fast timing window that completely catches the attackers off guard. Instead of saving Tailwind to escape, Baby Bay uses it almost like a Genji dash from Overwatch to get to positions that no other agent can reach as quickly. We see that again in the second clip where Baby Bay opens the round by dashing across a main to push ramps on Split. Thanks to a nice flash from his breach, Baby Bay takes out Reyna, smokes off the exit to the vent slash ropes area, and pushes deeper into A Heaven. Within just about 10 seconds, he has fully controlled the most important part of this site. He then uses his aggressive position to drop down onto the Killjoy who just killed his teammate Raze. This refreshes his Tailwind, and Baby Bay again uses it immediately to close the gap to screens and avoid his allied breach's stun. This repositioning without having to walk there is just fast enough to catch Omen and Sky on the rotation from B site. Instead of taking a 2v1 with low HP, however, Baby Bay pulls back into A site and ends up protecting the plant by spamming through the smoke. He then outduels the pushing Sky, refreshing Tailwind a second time this round and narrowly misses a huge ace against the Raze, who makes a nice blast pack play to win the round. Again, you can see that Baby Bay's aggressive movement allows him to quickly gain control of key areas of the map and collect crucial information by arriving places earlier than it is possible for any other agent to do so. These types of plays absolutely require you to hit your shots for maximum value, but still provide such immense pressure that a defensive setup will crumble anyway just because of how quickly they are forced to react. The last clip I wanted to break down really sums up Baby Bay's playstyle in a nutshell. Shower control is super important to fight for on Bind, so Baby Bay and Marv both push towards the orb and try to deny any aggressive move from the attacking Xset. Xset does a really good job of pushing back FaZe's defense with Raze and Sova utility. However, instead of backing out, Baby Bay actually uses the chaos and noise of the shock dart and exploding paint shells to push back through them into a forward position and lands a shot onto Sova while tanking some damage. Xset was so sure that they had pushed Jett off the angle that Sova never even fires his gun. As he so often does, Baby Bay has put himself in a very exposed position, and he knows that he needs to fight his way out of this corner. So he again aggressively swings into the open and clips the rays through the wall while rotating back towards the site. He then drops his operator for a phantom to take a more reliable fight, and again shows just enough patience to capitalize on the rays' attempt to jiggle peek him. Baby Bay then swaps back to the operator, knowing that multiple players in showers usually means that there is also a push coming through short A. Because he has already refreshed his tailwind, he confidently takes the duel against Omen and dashes to safety, only to immediately re-peek and nail a fourth kill. This last clip really highlights Baby Bay's true superpower, which is confidence. Even though the players he is challenging are just as high skill, the way he takes the fights is so decisive that it's making even really good opponents unsure of their next move. The simple threat that Baby Bay's jet is guaranteed to immediately be in their face every single round is throwing excellent players off their game. He's even admitted as much in post-game interviews, where Baby Bay actively talks about targeting the other team's superstar duelists to try and break them in the server. Baby Bay is a master at applying pressure, something that he perfected in the Overwatch League before, where his job was to constantly dive and punish the backline supports. Heavy pressure makes people play worse, make worse decisions, and rely on instinct over rational thought. This is just a fact of competitive existence. It often forces normally disciplined players to take awkward 1v1 aim duels or burn crucial utility to try and protect their positioning. Even when Baby Bay misses and dies way out of position, it might look really stupid, but it usually has given his teammates enough space and information to set up the rest of the round. Early on, Valorant has been an esport dominated by ex-Counter-Strike players and their structured style of play. The aggression, light-speed decision-making, and adaptability that has led to the success of players from Overwatch, Fortnite, and other games is making a strong case that Valorant is not just Counter-Strike with abilities anymore. We are witnessing the evolution of its own brand of highly strategic, but also highly creative gameplay that rewards those who are bold enough to push the limits of what other people might think is possible. That's it for this video. Hope you learned something. Let me know down in the comments below what pro player I should take a look at next. We'll see you next time.